To work with the P and ID line list in Plant 3D, it's essential to link the P and ID database with the 3D model database. Here's how we can proceed. Start by accessing the P and ID line list tool located in the parts insertion section of the ribbon menu. Once selected, we'll open a specific drawing. Here, we're using 08_02 model. At this point, the drawing appears blank, but we'll begin pulling in information directly from the P and ID line list. You don't need to open the P and ID drawing itself. Instead, head to the parts insertion panel where you'll find a list icon for the P and ID valve. This displays the available lines, valves, and their associated segments. When you click the icon, a dialog box will appear, providing a clear view of the P and ID data. If you recall, certain line numbers, such as 222, 333, and 1000, were defined earlier. By expanding these entries, you can see specific line segments, like 2-inch and 6-inch pipes, and any valves attached to them. To insert a line into the model, highlight the desired line segment. Let's start with the 6-inch segment. Right-click the segment and choose Place Item. You can then start routing the pipe directly in the 3D model. Notice that all the relevant information, such as line numbers, size, and specifications, is automatically transferred. For instance, the line might appear on layer 1000, matching the line number, and reflect its 6-inch size and associated spec. Repeat this process for other segments, like the 4-inch line under 222 and the 2-inch line under 333. First, simply highlight the segment, then right-click to place item. Finally, position it within the model. As you insert lines, you'll see that no manual adjustments are required. The details from the P and ID list, including size and specs, are seamlessly applied to the 3D model. This avoids unnecessary duplication of effort and simplifies the workflow. If you need constant access to the P and ID line list, you can dock the dialog box anywhere on the interface, top, bottom, or side, for convenience. Once the demonstration is complete, it's important to remove any redundant or duplicate lines. Simply select and delete the lines you've placed in the drawing to keep it clean as you move forward. This streamlined process makes it efficient to integrate P&ID data into the 3D environment without re-entering details manually.